Remember back in lesson 2, when Catherine used an async task hooked up to a refresh button to update our data? Reto talked about how that was a bad idea, because the async task is not tied to the activity lifecycle. The virtual machine will hold on to the activity object as long as the async task is running, even after Android is called on destroy for the activity and expects it to be discarded. If you rotate your phone, the behavior is to destroy your activity and instantiate a new one. The naive async task implementation now has two threads trying to perform the same update, and so forth. The point is, it's not the best pattern for a potentially very long background operation, such as fetching from web services. If you leave the app, the async task will continue to run for as long as your process is kept alive, but will run at a low priority, and your process will be the first thing to be killed if the device needs more resources. And there's a bigger problem. Your app has to be visible and running in the foreground to instantiate the task in the first place. Because we started a task to update the weather when we started the app, this can have undesirable behavior if the weather changes rapidly. So now we're going to learn the right way to perform updates. We'll want to automate the process while the app is in the foreground, but even more importantly, we want the app to get regular updates in the background with minimal battery drain. That will be especially important later in this lesson when we introduce weather notifications.